वेलकम टू द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग. द सब्जेक्ट कोड इज ईसीई 101. द टॉपिक ऑफ टूडेज वीडियो लेक्चर इज कंस्ट्रक्शन एंड वर्किंग प्रिंसिपल ऑफ डीसी मशीन्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डिस्कस व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय द डीसी मशीन. अ डीसी मशीन इज एन इलेक्ट्रोमैकेनिकल एनर्जी कन्वर्जन डिवाइस. देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ डीसी मशीन्स. One is DC generator and another one is DC motor. A DC generator converts mechanical power into electrical power, whereas DC motor converts DC electrical power into mechanical power. The AC motor is invariably applied in the industry for conversion of electrical power into mechanical power, but at the places where the wide range of speed and good speed regulation is required, like in electric traction system, a DC motor is used. So, first of all, the meaning of the machine which converts electromechanical energy. It is an electromechanical conversion device. We are having two types, DC generator and DC motor. DC generator converts mechanical power into the electrical power, and DC motor converts electrical power into the mechanical power. The construction of the DC motor and generator is nearly the same. The generator is employed in a very protected way. Hence, there is an open construction type, but the motor is used in the location where they are exposed to dust and moisture, and hence it requires enclosures, for example, dirt proof, fireproof, etc., according to the requirement. Although the battery is an important source of DC electric power, it can only supply limited power to any machine. There are some applications where large quantity of DC power are required, such as electroplating, electrolysis, etc. Hence, at such places, DC generators are used to deliver power. Now, we are discussing the construction of the DC machine. This is the basic construction parts of the DC machine, in which we are discussing all the parts one by one. The outer part, this outer part which is gray in color, is the frame or the yoke. This is frame. This is frame. This is the pole, field pole, which is in the blue color, north, south, north, south. These are the alternating poles. Then these are the field windings which are connecting to the field poles. Then we are having this circle, that is the armature, and in the armature we are having the circles. These are called armature conductors, and this inner circle in which we are having the segments, that is called commutator. And this black portion is called shaft, and this curvature is called pole shoe. So these are the main parts of the DC machine. We are discussing all these parts one by one. This diagram shows the yoke or the frame of the DC machine. The another name of the yoke is the frame. The main function of the yoke in the machine is to offer mechanical support intent for poles and protect the entire machine from moisture, dust, etc. The material used for the yoke are designed with cast iron, cast steel, otherwise rolled steel. This is important. The material used for the making the frame is cast iron, cast steel, or the rolled steel. Then pole and pole core. This is the diagram for the pole and pole core. The pole of the DC machine is an electromagnet and the field winding is the winding among the poles. The outside of the pole we are having the field windings. Here we are having the field windings, and whenever the field winding is energized, then the pole gives the magnetic flux. When we are giving the supply to these field windings, they get energized and they are producing the magnetic flux because this pole is magnetic. The material used for this are cast steel, cast iron. It can be built with the annealed steel laminations for reducing the power drop because of the eddy current. This diagram shows the construction of the pole and the pole core. This shows the laminated shoes, laminated pole core, topped hole for fixing. These are the holes which are on the poles. These are for fixing on the yoke, and these are the rivets. Then section of field winding. These are the field windings. Here, as I have previously mentioned, these are the field windings which are energized for producing the magnetizing flux. Then pole shoes. This diagram shows the pole shoes. This curvature is called the pole shoe, and this part is called pole core, and here we are having the field winding. The pole shoe in the DC machine is an extensive part as well as to enlarge the region of the pole. Why we are having the curvature? To enlarge the region of the pole. Because of this region, the flux can spread out within the air gap as well as extra flux can be passed through the air space towards the armature. For spreading the maximum flux, we are having this curvature shape. The material used to build pole shoe is cast iron, otherwise cast steel. This is L. And also used annealed steel laminations to reduce the loss of power because of eddy current. Field winding. The sides of the pole core are field windings. These are the field windings, as written here. In this, the field windings are wound in the region of the pole core and named as field winding. Whenever current is supplied through the field winding, then it electromagnetics the poles, which generate required flux. The material used for the field winding is copper material. These are the wires which are wound round the pole core, and it is of the material copper. It is very important to know that what is the function of field windings and what is the function of armature winding. The winding through which a current is passed to produce the main flux is called field winding, and winding in which the voltage is induced is called armature winding. So for current, field winding; for voltage, we are having the armature winding. This shows the diagram of next part is armature core, and this diagram shows the armature core. This is armature core, and it has a number of slots. These are the slots. These are different slots. These are also called teeth, and this is the magnetic pole. This is the air gap between the poles and the armature core, and these are the slots. In these slots we are having the conductors, and here we are having the armature windings. And this shows the side view of the armature. This shows the laminations, craft and commutator. So this is the complete armature. And armature core includes a huge number of slots within its edges. These are the slots which are in the edges. The armature conductor is located in these slots. These are the conductors, small round balls. These are called conductors, which are situated in the slots. It provides the low reluctance path towards the flux generated with field winding. The material used for this core are permeability, low reluctance material like iron, otherwise cast iron. The lamination is used to decrease the loss because of eddy current. This diagram shows the armature, the slots, teeth and shaft, and this is shows the internal structure of a single slot. This is a view of single slot in which we are having the cotton tap, insulating paper, conductors, wedge, and this is armature slot. Then armature winding. Armature winding can be formed by interconnecting the armature conductor. Whenever an armature winding is turned with the help of prime mover, then the voltage as well as magnetic flux gets induced within it. This winding is aligned to an exterior circuit. The material used for this winding are conducting materials like copper. Armature windings are used for producing the voltage as well as the magnetic flux, and they are connecting to the external circuit by and they are moving with the help of prime mover. These are the parts. When we are talking about the single turn, this is the single turn in which we are having S and F. S means start and F means finish, and this is the conductor, and this single is called single turn. A turn consists of two conductors connected to one end by an end conductor. And coil, a coil is formed by connecting several turns in series. These all are connected in series with each other, one end to the another end. So when number of turns are connected, that becomes a coil. When the number of coils are connected in series, that becomes the winding. A winding is formed by connecting several coils in series. So this is the figure of coil, and this is the figure of winding. So this is how the armature windings are there. Then commutator. It is the important part of the construction of the DC machine. The function of the commutator is to collect current from the armature coil and convert the alternating current into unidirectional current for the external load circuit. As the armature coils are producing the alternating current, and when it passes through the commutator, it converts it into the unidirectional. Means when we are having this type of current, it converts the current into unidirectional. Each coil of the armature winding is connecting to the commutator bar. Therefore, the number of commutator segments are equal to the number of coils. The armature conductors are connected to the commutator with the help of riser. And commutator segments are wedge shaped, and each segment is held together by means of V shaped steel rings. So it is important to know the function of the commutator. Means the function of the commutator is to convert the alternating current into the unidirectional current for external load circuit. And the number of the commutator segments are equal to the number of coils. Then brushes and brush holders. These are the brushes which are connecting to the sides of the commutator. The function of the brush is to collect current from the commutator for the external circuit. It transfers the current from the commutator to the external circuit. The brushes are made up of hard carbon or metal and are in shape of rectangle, which are metal box type. This diagram shows the internal structure of the brushes, and these are the main parts of the brushes: brush, brush box, main body, pigtail, then slots, lever, nut bolts and spring. So these are the main parts of the brush. So the function, important thing is the function of the brush. means that it collects current from the commutator for the external circuit. Next moves to the working principle of DC generator or DC motor. The working principle of DC motor generator is same. According to the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, we know that when a current carrying conductor is placed in a varying magnetic field, an EMF is induced in the conductor. So when a conductor is moving in a magnetic field, an EMF is generated. According to Fleming's right hand rule, the direction of the induced current changes whenever the direction of the motion of the conductor changes. The direction of the current changes according to the motion of the conductor, and it follows the Fleming's right hand rule. Then an armature rotating clockwise and the conductor at the left moving upwards. When the armature completes half rotation, the direction of the motion of the conductor will be reversed. Hence, the direction of the current in every armature will be alternating. But with the help of split ring commutator, the connection of the armature conductors get reversed when the current reversal occurs. Therefore, we get unidirectional current at the terminals. So, when the conductor is moving in the magnetic field, EMF is induced, and when the directions are changing, it produces the alternating current. When this alternating current passes through the split ring commutator, it gets converted into the unidirectional current. So, the important parts, essential parts of the generator are magnetic field, the conductors which move inside the magnetic field. Then this shows the working principle of the DC generator, in which in the magnetic field we are having the north and south poles, and the conductor is moving in the magnetic field. Here the commutator and the split rings are there. This is the split ring and the brushes, which converts the current into the unidirectional. This is another diagram. This shows the waveform of the current as well. Conductor is moving in the magnetic field, and it is giving the unidirectional current. Single loop DC generator. These figures shows how the coil is moving in the magnetic field. So first it shows the direction A, B, C and D, and then it moves to the 90 degree. Then it will become in this shape. Then it again moves to the 90 degree. Then it becomes in this shape. And when it becomes again to the 90 degree, it becomes to this shape. When it is in this direction, means it is at the 90 degree and towards the axis, then the maximum flux is passing through it. But when it is there in this direction, the minimum flux is passing through the conductor. And when again in this position, the maximum flux is passing, but in the opposite direction. Similarly, here the minimum flux is passing. So based on this working principle of DC generator, here we shown the conductor connecting to the motor, and how it shows its directions. As we see that in the first half of the revolution, the current always flow. This shows the direction of the current. It flows A, B, L, M, C and D. Brush number 1, this brush number 1 in contact with the segment A, this is the segment A of the split ring. In the next half cycle, when the directions are reversed, it will become as shown here, it will become D, C, L, M, B, A. So when this its direction is reversed, here it also changes B to A. So now the B is connecting to the brush 1. So in the next half revolution, in the figure, the direction of the induced current in the coil is reversed, but at the same time the position of the segment A and B are also reversed. When the direction of these coils are changing, the direction of this A and B are also changing, which results that brush number 1 comes in contact with segment 1. And when it is AB, LM, CD, it is A is connecting with A. When the direction is changed, then B is connecting with A. Hence, the current in the load resistance again flows from L to M. Because of this reversal, but the direction of the current in this coil because of this brush remains the same. So, it gives a unidirectional current as shown in this. This is the first half cycle when A, B, L, M, C, D is the circle. In the next cycle, when the directions are C, D, C, L, M, B, A, then it gives this cycle. It gives this cycle, but at this time it B is connecting to 1, and in this way, in this loop, it is connecting A with 1. So when we are having this flow, the brush 1 is connecting to A. When we are having this loop, then B is connecting to 1. Because of this, the brush 1 is connecting with A and B, so the direction in this resistance will remain same. So that's why we are getting the unidirectional current. So the position, the position of the brushes of DC generator are so that the change over of the segments A and B from one brush to other takes place when the plane of rotating coil is at a right angle to the plane of the lines of force. It is to become in that position, the induced EMF in the coil is zero. So this is all about the working principle of DC generator. Hope you like this lecture. Thank you very much.